Hey, how's it going, everyone? Welcome back to Emnix Plays Path of Exile. Vigil. Prophecy League. Yeah. Vigil. Vigilance strikes also fortifies nearby enemy or allies. That's cool. Anyways, we are now in Act 2. And last time around, we spent an hour in the Chamber of Sins, but now we have collected the Baleful Gem as well as Malagaro's Spike. I went and purchased my Rise of the Phoenix, so it is lying here in wait. We are currently level 63.9, so we're basically one level away from using Rise of the Phoenix and probably Righteous Fire as well. Now today, we've already killed Alira. We should probably go and kill Kraytlin, get our final endurance charge, which brings us up to 7 endurance charges, and then I want to say move on to Vale, but we probably want to do the quest to do our final trial. We should probably do that today. Oh my god, why is my mana so bad? I mean, I feel like once we get to Righteous Fire time, mana regen won't be a problem. I think I have something else turned on, don't I? I have Purity of Fire turned on. Alright, at this point I'm still, you know, kind of chugging, we're still chugging mana pots, and I still haven't found a ruby flask. Which is a problem, right? Like, once you get to start using Righteous Fire, you need a Dispel Burning Flask. For sure. So I gotta get my hands on a Ruby Flask ASAP. I'm also leveling a Flame Surge on the side right now. Because we will need that for once we switch over to Righteous Fire. I want to do Flame Surge, Righteous Fire. I don't want to do Flame Blast, Righteous Fire. It just doesn't feel right. And as you can see, like, with with Flame Blast, you know, we're running into a lot of mana problems. Now, I do recognize that Flame Surge might have less damage than Righteous Fire, than Flame Blast, or it for sure does. I don't know. We'll have to see. The nice thing about Flame Blast is sort of, it's a great leveling skill, and the reason it's a great leveling skill is you don't have to put much investment into it at all, and you still get, you know, a whole lot of benefit out of it. Now, I have a choice right now. I could either get more dex slash int nodes so I can switch out my gear, or take the final 0.5 regen. 0.5 regen per second. I mean, it's not that much. I think dex and int is more important. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to take some intelligence. I'm going to take hard knocks, and then I can level flame blast as well. And this way, I can actually switch out my rings should I need to for some better rings. Because right now, I think I'm relying on my rings and amulets for a lot of stats. And it's stats that I need, admittedly, but, oh, let's go, oh my god, I need to go back to Vorichi and see which direction he was pointing. Where am I supposed to go? This way. But yeah, it's stats I need, but I don't want it on my ring. Now I know one of the best ways to get stats is to Mastercraft it, which is a possibility. Oh, keep the target on low life, okay. Oh my god. Ground slam like mad. Luckily we have pretty good armor and physical mitigation, so he's not doing too much damage to us, but still. Yo, can I just tank it? Oh my god. Oh, I feel so strong. What up, bro? You can't even do anything. Wow. Now obviously once we do start using Righteous Fire, it won't be like that, since Righteous Fire is going to consume a lot of the regen that we currently do have, or it's going to negate it. I right now I tried turning on Righteous Fire and I'm still degenning. So pretty much I cannot do this without my Rise of the Phoenix. So clearly it is an endgame thing, and we are about to hit it soon, though. We are 4% to 65, which, let me tell you, I'm super excited to start using RF. Very excited. I'm like all giddy and shit. Oh, what happened to my golem? Here you go. Oh, but my resistances are complete and utter shit. Oh my god, look at that. 70, 61, 49? Really? I didn't know they were that bad. Admittedly, my belt, terrible. The rings, pretty bad. All the gear is pretty bad. We're gonna need to try and find some better gear. I think this chest is the best piece of gear I have so far. And it's pretty good, I think. At least for me. The chaos resistance is actually probably really good. It's probably really great. Now that I think about it. I could go over here and pick up more chaos resistance as well afterwards. Anyways, Kraytlin. Kill Kraytlin. Now, these guys shouldn't be a problem either. I mean, we have pretty good regen. I don't think these guys should do any damage to us. Especially now I have all this physical damage. Yeah, we do. We have 70% physical damage reduction. What up, bro? What up, dog? What can you even do? I'm just gonna sit here. Oh, hit me. Kill me! That's right. You can't! All of a sudden, we got so strong just by switching over the armor piece? Is that what it was? I don't know. Whatever it was. We're like awesome now. Okay. I mean, resistance is still shit. You know, if we take like really bad elemental damage, we're still gonna take it up the butt. So without endurance charges, we have 46% damage reduction, which is already pretty good, let me tell you. I think that's pretty good. With endurance charges, we go up to 70%. And our gear isn't that good just yet. I'm excited, man. I'm excited. I'm excited for a build to become a thing. Let me switch this over. Why do I have... Oh, Veil Flame Blast. Flame Blast, Veil Flame Blast. Okay. But yeah, like I said, so today we have to finish the trial in Act 2 so we can eventually do our Ascendancy. Speaking of Ascendancy, so we should actually look at doing our Cruel Ascendancy soon as well. I think I want to do it when I hit 65. I want to use Righteous Fire to do the Cruel Ascendancy. It just seems like the perfect time to sort of challenge ourselves, you know? So I'm going to wait until then before I actually do that. Okay. Oh, another yellow. Flame Surge is getting leveled up, which is good. I got it while it was still level 1, so there's still a lot of leveling to do for Flame Surge. What is its damage like now? 1148. What is that? Oh my god, the damage is awful. But attacks pretty fast. Now, obviously it doesn't have any support gems on it. What happens if I put some support gems on this thing? Let's see, Flame Blast, Elemental Focus, Control Destruction. Okay. So Flame Surge. 2000 DPS. What is that? That's still pretty bad. Doesn't actually kill anything. Look at that! It just pokes them. Compared to 10 stack of Flame Blast, even without any support gems, still kills it. Excuse me. That sucks. It still needs more levels. What's Flame Surge? Level 5. Yeah. It's still pretty low. Gotta wait and see how it's like when it's like level, I don't know, like 15 or something. The Union. 10 Gen Cutter's Prisms. Like, I like these cards and all, but I'm never gonna actually collect 10 Union cards, you know? It's just taking up inventory space, that's all. But it does kind of motivate me to collect them all. In maps, though, you know, not actually in Felshrine. I'm not gonna come here just to farm 10 Union cards. That seems like a waste of time. Oh. Give me 1 second. Sorry, I just kind of kept playing, but I had to take a call, so I had to mute my mic. Well, I see the trials. They're right here. Let's do them. Trials of Ascendancy. Thing is, we have so much HP regen. I think we can just kind of run into the traps, right? Okay, not really. No. I regret doing that. We can kind of do it, though. I mean, this is probably the best kind of labyrinth runner you can get, right? Someone with a lot of HP regen, who can just sort of tank the traps. That's probably what you want. Oh, excuse me. All right, trial complete. We might as well do the quest here. I mean, we're already here. But I just want to run through this. I mean, otherwise, it's gonna take too long. Okay. So really, we have enough regen that we can mitigate a lot of the damage that these guys do to me. We just gotta make sure we don't get bursted down. And probably a lot of the burst is going to come from elemental damage. We have to make sure that we cap our resistances. 49% lightning resistance in Merciless, let me tell you, that is not good. This is actually really bad. Like, I'm actually really scared of dying. And it really could happen. 3,000 life, I mean, it's a decent buffer, but still. It's still scary. Okay, let's just look for the boss and get this over with. Flame Surge leveled up. Okay. Weapon elemental damage. Nice. Okay. I'm still a little sick. But I'm getting better now, so I think I'll be able to play a bit more. It's just when you play and you're recording and you're talking, when you're sick, it's not a good combination, you know? You don't want to talk when you're sick, you just want to, like, I don't mind playing by myself and then, you know, not talking and not recording, but I mean, where's the fun in that? So it basically means when I'm sick, I'm just playing less, which has been really hard to do this league, because I know that this league has been getting a lot of flack. Some people don't enjoy doing the low level prophecies. Obviously, we're not on maps yet, so we haven't run into that situation, but I'm enjoying the prophecies so far, even if I have to go to like a easier place to do it, like an easier level, or, you know, go back to cruel or whatever. Like, I'm enjoying it. You know, some people just want to run their content, they want to run their maps, which is fine, but I'm just saying, you know, it's not that bad. This is a good league. I find it really hard to sort of put down the mouse and walk away, because I just want to keep playing. Mm-hmm. And sell that. We have 4 coins. I think it's time to do some prophecies. Seek prophecy. Feral Lord 2! Nice. Second part of the chain. And valuable combination. You will receive an extra chaos orb from a vendor when you trade items that would result in a chaos orb. I mean, that's not gonna happen until we start doing 65 zones, right? Level 65 or level 60 zones. 65? 60? Might be level 60. PoE. Chaos recipes? Vendor recipes. Chaos orb 60 to 674. Okay, so if we have level 60 items, we can get the chaos recipe. So we should start collecting rare items then. Right? And we can do this prophecy here. The Union. Straight up. It looks like the guy's about to sexually assault this girl. I don't know why that was my first thought, but I'm like, this girl does not want to be here. She doesn't want this. Card. The sexual assault card. Seriously, if you just quickly glance at it, doesn't it look like the guy's about to force himself on her? It just doesn't seem right. Or is that just me? Maybe it's the way his hands are placed. You know, they would look more in love if he was actually holding her hand. But instead, you know, he's got both his hands on her waist as if he's about to thrust. Anyways, I don't want to talk about it. Okay, Yina, golden hand. Oh, let me see what you got for me. Reduce mana reserve, increase skill effect duration, reduce mana cost. Reduce mana reserved? Like auras? That's cool. Avoid elemental status ailments, dodge attacks, effect of your curses. I mean, I guess I'll take this. The Conqueror's Potencies is pretty good too. To be honest, we don't need any of this, right? We're not doing curses, we're not doing auras. I mean, reduced mana cost is probably what we want, because we do have mana issues. But I don't even know if we need jewel sockets in this build. I don't think we do. Originally, I had planned this build to have some jewel sockets, like one right here or something like that. I don't know anymore. Maybe we use it as life. Hopefully we can get more than 5% life. And then spell damage. I think that's as much as we can hope for with jewel sockets. Because there's no life regen with jewels, I recently found out. Which kind of blows, to be real with ya. Anyways, riverways. Let's go do oak. And by doing oak, we mean let's help oak. Not doing oak. Hunter's Resolve. Hey. Unique bow. It could be anything. It could be a Voltaxic. Or it could even be a boat. Alright. Which way do I go? Aren't I supposed to follow the cobblestone path? I can't tell where this cobblestone path is going. What? Where's the cobblestone path? This way? Oh yeah, okay. Okay. Wow, Curtis's crematorium, so that's Act 3. Level 27 already, that's nice. Alright, so we want to help Oak. Remember, we want to help Oak. Let's not fuck up and kill him by accident. And I would really like to hit level 65, please. The sooner that can happen, the better. Help Oak. Oh, yes. We are now at 7 endurance charges. Oh, baby. A triple. I cannot do this yet. So we have 74% physical damage mitigation. We still take quite a bit of burst damage. This is chaos damage, I guess. But with seven endurance charges, that brings us up to an additional 3 point. No. Each endurance charge gives us 0.2 regen. So 7, we got another 1.4 HP regen per second. Not bad. Oh, what's this? Is that a ghost? Can I taunt the ghost? No. Yo, dog, can you go that way, please? How is there no rare around here? Man, that blows. Was there a rare here? There wasn't. Okay, well, shit happens, I guess. All right. So over here, I'm gathering a little necrotic. Revive, bring it to the sculpture, which is this way apparently. I hope it's not too far. I really dislike Katarina missions. I actually dislike Tora missions more nowadays. I'm actually kind of okay with Katarina missions. I mean, it's not too much trouble. Like, look, we just got to bring it over here and then we probably got to kill this thing. Yep. Yeah, it's not that bad. Mission complete. So what were my prophecies? I would find, okay, the chain is I would encounter a powerful beast in Northern Forest. Are there any other ones? These are labyrinth quests. You will be rewarded with 2 uses of the enchantment device on completing the labyrinth. That's pretty dope. So I get, I guess, 1 for the boot, 1 for the gloves. This would be better in Merciless since you can enchant the helmet twice. So you can get like either 2 good enchants, or you could actually like look for like a particular helmet enchant. And it's even better if you were to use it in Uber. The Uber Labyrinth. I didn't even think about that. Anyways. Okay. Let's just do this really quick. How much time have we been playing for? Okay, 24 minutes. Not too bad. We're probably stopping. Well, I was going to say that we're going to stop after a certain period of time, but I guess we stop after we kill Vale. That's probably the best way to do it. That way we have sort of a little bit of an objective that we can work towards. But I do want to finish all that before the 35-minute mark. So we're talking within the next 10 minutes I want to kill Vale. Some of you might be thinking, getting to Vale within 10 minutes from Merciless Ruins, it's not that bad. If that's the case, if that's what you're thinking, you clearly have not been watching my series all that much. Oh, hello.
Hello.
So how's your, I see you're in Act 3 now.
Yeah.
Did I tell you I found an Exalted Orb today?
No. Cool. In this league.
No, it was like a bit earlier. In this league, yes.
Oh, cool. Did you see I got this? I don't know. Is this an item that is in every single kill of dude guy? Or is that actually special?
That's a special jewel.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot of those.
Okay. Yeah, dropped from Act 2 boss.
Oh yeah?
I didn't know if he like automatically dropped a unique.
No, it's not an automatic thing.
Okay.
But I think unique jewels drop pretty often. But there are just so many of them. It's like hard to it's hard to find a use for them sometimes. They target very specific, like very niche builds. Some builds obviously use it a lot, but some don't. For example, that item is really only useful in a party.
Yeah. But
it's cool though. There's a lot of cool jewels when they implemented it.
Seems like it.
Yeah.
So my poor Red Sox got beaten up bad today.
Your what? Oh.
My poor Red Sox.
Yeah.
In a way.
Was that the Jays game?
No, against Baltimore.
Okay. There were a lot of people watching today. It was crazy out.
Yeah. Well, it was a day game, right? So.
Yeah.
A lot of people take the day off. And
I don't get it, though. I mean, there are so many games.
Yeah, and they're all amazing.
I mean, sure.
You get, what other sport do you get 162 games?
Fair enough, but it's like, if there are so many games, is it worth taking a day off to see it?
Whenever you can have a game like today. Totally.
Why, is it a big deal?
Well, I mean, they ended up scoring, I think, 9 runs in 3 innings.
Oh,
the
yeah.
First three.
That's true.
It was. Get to see a Josh Donaldson Grand Slam.
Grand Slam, that's true.
Mm-hmm. Anyways.
Ancestors, forgive me. I have opened the. Oh, my God.
What's up?
It's time to do a prophecy quest chain. This is the second part. It's actually so hard to find these chains. Did you know what they are? You know the prophecies?
Well, what?
You can get like a quest chain. So you get a quest, like part 1, part 2, I think up to like part 5.
Okay.
And at the end you get something cool. Or like a key piece. And then when you combine all the pieces, you get to do like a unique map.
Oh, that's pretty neat.
Mm-hmm.
Huh. Just having a fight against the Weapon Master for the first time here.
Weapon Master?
He's like the dual guy. Is it the Master?
Oh, is this a... Oh, DeResso. Right?
Or Vagan.
Oh, Vagan. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Don't have anybody at level 3 yet. But so cool.
Right. Yeah, once you get a hideout, it's really useful because you can start crafting. Well, you always could, but it was like really RNG based. This kind of normalizes it a little. You'll see once you get a hideout.
Okay. Yeah. Eventually. Things are moving pretty quick. I mean,
are you still using that same bow?
I got a unique from a thing, but I don't know if it's any as good. It's kind of a side grade, but it's unique, so I'm using it.
Okay.
Wrath's Reach. It has a skills chain one time.
That's fine for leveling.
It's kind of, yeah, it's okay.
It's really good for lightning arrow, actually.
Yeah, it's pretty reasonable.
Because if they pack up together.
Oh yeah, then it just kind of goes.
Yeah.
But the other one did more damage, so.
Well, you gotta LMP it, right? Did you do that?
Do a what?
Lesser multiple projectiles.
Oh yeah. Yeah, already got that on. Oh, neat. I got a prophecy where I just killed a dude and now I have his mods.
Oh, yeah. That one's pretty dope.
They're pretty shitty mods, but oh well.
Yeah, but still. You feel like powerful for like 20 seconds. There's a belt that lets you take a rare mods when you kill it. For 20 seconds. It's in very high demand.
Can't imagine. Just for giggles, right?
Yeah. A lot of people want it, though.
Oh, a lot of giggles. God.
That was the prophecy boss. Fucking his ice crash, like, hits the whole screen. That was pretty cool.
Yeah, these prophecies are pretty neat.
Yeah, I like them. Some people complain in the end game that it forces you to go down to like the lower levels. You know how some prophecies are like you will do something in Act 2 or you will do something in Act 3, and yeah. people are like in maps already and they don't want to go down to Act 2. Like, I get it. At the same time, it's a change of pace that, you know, that I don't mind.
Well, if you don't want,
yeah, you can seal it up.
Yeah. Oh shit, Piety.
Piety.
I forgot about this part. Yeah, like the little mini Piety.
Right.
I just walked into her and was like, ah! They really shortened up Act 3.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, it's intensely.
But it's like a good. It's like a good length, I think.
I guess.
Before it was way too long. Like, the sewers, Solaris had like 3 levels, Lunaris had 3 levels. It was crazy. Alright, caverns time! Time to do Veil. Oh, I'm so close to level 65. I can't wait.
What do you get at 65?
Rise of the Phoenix is the shield. Oh my god, this guy hurts.
Okay, and so you got one already?
Huh?
You got it already?
I bought it already, yeah.
Okay.
And then it gives +8 to max fire resist, which means I can start using Righteous Fire, hopefully. I'm not too sure. I think I'll be able to regen past the fire degen, but you don't know.
Do you have the fire resist aura, or is that kind of silly?
I do. So that one gives me another +2 to max. So I can get myself up to 86.
That's like that 2%, 84 to 86 is functionally equivalent to what? It's like.
What do you mean?
84-16 is 16% damage, so.
Yeah, it's 16%. So, Righteous Fire takes 90% of your HP.
Yeah.
And.
So yeah, every little bit helps a lot.
Oh yeah. Especially since your life regen nodes only go up to maybe, like right now, I think I have 11.6 just in regen. And then there's Vitality Aura, which gives me another 1.4. So that brings me up to 13. And then Endurance Charges gives me another 1.4, so that gives me up to 14.4. So I'm pretty close. Oh my. I have like no lightning resistance. And this guy's using Storm Call. Oh, it hurts. Okay, did it. I found this piece of armor though. It was a big upgrade for me.
Oh man, that's nice.
Yeah.
All that armor and life and resists.
Yeah, it's everything I need pretty much. I mean, I wouldn't mind if I had a bit more resist, but it has chaos resistance, which is pretty good. That's something that's pretty hard to stack up.
And a little bit of that makes a
difference. Especially since you at Immerseless you have negative 60. Hey, this guy's inner treasure. I wonder what I'm gonna get. God damn it. Drumroll.
You got all of shit.
All of nothing.
Man.
Yeah, I'll show you. There you go.
Score.
Got him.
I threw this guy into the guild stash earlier. One second.
Gore breaker. Ah, it's that thing, isn't it? Yep. I mean, I have a prophecy that lets me turn in 5 unique and get a new unique. I think I'm gonna use it on all my trash uniques.
We can use that one if you want. This Poacher's Mark looks like kind of a cool curse.
Sorry?
This one, Poacher's Mark, looks like a kind of cool
curse. Oh yeah, that one
makes them less evasive. And yes. Give more flask charges and frenzy charges.
Mm-hmm. Oh. They've renamed some of them, like what was it? It might have been. Maybe this is a new curse, but this might be projectile weakness. No, it's not. Never mind. But Assassin's Mark used to be critical weakness.
Okay.
Poacher's Mark might be a new thing. I can't remember. It's been so long. Join my guild. Invite.
Got some new guild ace.
Yeah, people want to join. And we don't really have anything super expensive in guild stash, so I don't mind.
We have that breaker. Man, that breaker.
The gore breaker. Oh no, the gore breaker. Save it! God. Save it before he takes it!
Super important stuff. Thank you.
Alright. And a couple imaginary ones. Who never log on, apparently.
Yep.
Yep. See, I don't understand guilds in Path of Exile, because it's not like you can do raids or anything like that, you know? There isn't too much of a benefit to the guild system. The only benefit I see to a guild system in Path of Exile is you can share your inventory, you can chat with people in your guild easily without having to, you know, invite everybody to a party or whisper everybody all together. It's kind of like a WhatsApp group. Other than that, you know, there's no real benefits to a guild. So how does a guild get too serious? I don't understand. It's not like they're like, oh, you must donate X number of items every couple days.
Are you sure?
In order to maintain our guild funds. Like, what?
Guild funds. They'll run out of... I don't know what you would run out of.
Yeah, what would you run out of? There's no maintenance.
Yeah, if you don't donate, then I don't know. You'll be homeless. Is that a good item?
A Death's Harp?
Yeah.
It's like okay damage, but it gives you an extra arrow.
That's kind of interesting.
It's the one that shoots two arrows.
And are they like at the same target?
Huh?
Are they at the same target? Or is it just like a extra
It's like arrow you have lesser multiple projectiles equipped, but you have one extra projectile. Or just one extra projectile. I guess.
What's the level?
I want to say 30-some, but I'm not too sure. Return, you must. Ooh. 20% map. That's pretty sweet.
Or do I have nothing that would be...
No, it's not expensive. I imagine that thing's worth like an elk. A chaos at most. If he asks for more, he's ripping you off.
Oh, sweet. Skeleton shrine.
Nice.
Yeah, come my minions. Oh, what a flame. Made it to the end of the map.
All right. Oh, I got so many silver coins. Oh, two drops. This is so sweet.
Oh. Are they tradable and everything?
They are, yeah.
I don't imagine they sell for very much, though.
It's like 10 of them for a chaos, or maybe more now. Maybe like 15 of them for a chaos. Which isn't that bad.
Easy, you can get some neat stuff.
I mean, you can collect 10 coins pretty quickly.
Yeah.
Oh god, I just realized this place. This guy does lightning damage, doesn't he? Oh, that's a problem. Alright. I'm gonna hope for the best here. Ooh! I'm level 65! Yeah. Okay, before I do Veil, I want to test this out. Time to see how good this is. I should test it in hideout first, so I don't accidentally kill myself.
Where's the fun in that?
Where's the fun if you don't know if you're gonna die or not?
Yeah.
All right. So.
Gotta veil all your shit.
Gotta veil all my shit.
Purity
of fire. Okay, I can sustain it pretty well.
Okay.
I have 480 life regen. 86. Okay, now I don't have a dispel flask. That is a problem. Do I have a ruby flask? God damn it, I don't.
What kind of flask do you need?
A ruby. There's a fire one. Okay. I cannot do this without a ruby flask. That's just way too dangerous.
Oh, just in case somebody like hits you with with like a fire debuff or an elemental.
In case I actually want to stop the degen for some reason. I'll put in a bismuth.
Oh, so it just keeps on going until you like make it to town or something
until
like
I
that?
Until I die, yeah.
Oh, that's Nick. That's okay.
Okay. No, that's the wrong one. Damn it! Remove shock, remove freeze, but not remove burning. Come on, dog.
Come on.
Just give me what I want.
You can do it.
Iron skin. Yep. No. Remove shock.
No.
Bleeding? No. Although it's a pretty good one. No. Speed. Resistance. Reflex. Resistance. Dowsing. Okay, that's the one I want. Let's get rid of a Quicksilver. I don't think we need it anymore. I don't need to run fast.
That's pretty heretical. That's like old Chohan talking. Old. Didn't yesterday teach you anything?
No, we don't need to run fast. We're fine. So we turn on Righteous Fire. And then we hope for the best. I wonder how much damage this does. Around 400 DPS, I guess. Oh wait, no. Maybe more? Less?
So AoE all around you?
Oh shit, where's Righteous Fire? Let's equip it with Flame Blast. Okay, let's see. How much does this do? This is like no damage! What? Oh, wait. Hold up. I have the wrong gems, I think.
Okay.
Righteous Fire. Increased burning. Increased burning damage. Concentrated effect. Increased AoE.
Isn't the idea, though, that it just increases the damage of everything else that you do, rather than being really powerful itself? Or...
Well, it does damage... The degen also damages others, right?
Okay.
Okay, so this does... I have no idea, I can't tell. But it has increased area of effect, concentrated effect, increased burning damage. And then... I don't have any others.
Is that going to hurt you more, too?
Yeah, no. No, it doesn't.
No? Okay.
Okay, let's take this and roll a couple slots on it for now. And color it blue, blue, red. Please. Okay, Flame Blast. Iron Will. And elemental focus. Oh, I'm so stupid. Okay, I know what happened, why I wasn't doing any damage to it. I had my Righteous Fire connected to something called Elemental Focus, which means skills cannot inflict elemental status ailments. So I couldn't
burn. Oh, so it couldn't burn?
I couldn't burn him. I'm like, oh, there's no damage.
I'm burning.
Okay, this is a lot better.
Okay.
Oh my!
Are you alive?
Yeah, I got zapped. That was not cool. Okay, let's just do this. We'll run around him. And slowly burn him. Alright, it's working.
Okay. That's...
Can I try, let's see. Let's try Flame Surge. How does that do? I mean, there's some damage there. Flame Blast is still better, though. Okay.
You're walking a very fine line.
Oh, definitely. Let me tell you, never do Veil with 47% lightning resistance. Not a good idea. No. Terrible idea, in fact.
And then also running around with a self-debuff.
Yeah, self-debuff too. Okay, well, we managed to kill Veil, so that's good. Oh, I guess we're done. I'm gonna have to look at this build a bit more. Figure out our gem slots. I want to put Righteous Fire on a 4 link, but not in the chest, because I eventually want to put Flame Surge on a 6 link, or at least a 5 link. Next episode, maybe I'll be switching over to Flame Surge, Righteous Fire right away. I'll have to see. And we're going to be in Act 3 next time, so I'll probably do some farming in Act 3. And if I like how the build is going, I'm probably going to do Cruel Labyrinth. We still haven't done that, even though we're in Merciless Act 3 already. But that's it for this episode. Thank you guys very much for watching. Once again, if you enjoyed it, as always, you could leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more daily updates in the future. We have a Discord channel. If you want to join, you can check out the description bar down below. Otherwise, keep in touch, guys, and I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.